Coming up today, a lady is told she's too late to check in even though her flight is delayed.
But you're not on time, you're not leaving on time. The plane is sitting there on the runway.
Another passenger demands a refund.
Don't go.
I understand, excuse me.
Give me my money because I come to pay this here.
And a drunken Irishman tries to find his way back home.
How do we get to Dublin?
We don't travel to Dublin, so you won't be travelling with us.
Yeah. How do we get to Dublin?
However you
want
to get to Dublin.
Come fly with me. Let's fly away.
Hello everyone and welcome to another episode of Arthur TV's Airline UK Freakouts. It's another busy day for EasyJet and already there are delays. A technical problem is holding up the flight to Zurich and the dispatcher's priority is to get it back on schedule as soon as possible. EasyJet have said no to a passenger who's turned up late for the flight, but inside the terminal, the argument isn't over.
You're trying, you're just not being flexible enough. Part of this service, customer service, is about flexibility.
Not when it comes to our on-time performance.
But you're not on time, you're not leaving on time. The plane is sitting there on the runway.
If we accept you, the aircraft will be delayed further, and that can't happen. I checked with dispatch and we can't get you on it.
Mrs Choti had planned to meet her husband at the airport for their flight home to Zurich, but she arrived after the check-in had closed.
I'm due on the flight, 6:20 to Zurich tonight. My husband, who is also in London, has made it because he's probably got the train's connections properly. I didn't make it. I've been rushing here to get here. And I've just missed it. There's 20 minutes still to go for the plane. I mean, I've been queuing here. There's no customer service. Nobody's saying, are you trying to get to Zurich? What time? Whatever. Just queue up here until you scream and shout. So I'm trying to get on the 6:20 flight, which is delayed, which isn't leaving. It's sitting on the runway, but I can't get on it.
Every day, St. Leo deals with the same demands from late passengers, but it's dispatchers who call the shots, and there's only so much he can do.
We've just tried. You can listen to me double check. Wait there. No chance at all. No. Okay, thanks. We can't get you on it.
Why not?
Because the check-in's closed and all the figures and all the paperwork's gone to the dispatcher now. You've seen me try with the dispatcher. What else do you expect me to do?
I've got half my family on the fly.
Yup, because they arrived on time, you divvy.
I can't. Your family's on the flight?
Yes, you can ask. You can check if my husband's
irrelevant
on the flight.
Irrelevant of that, I can't get you on.
It is absolutely irrelevant that she's got family on the flight. As always, St. Leo is spot on and to the point. Whilst all of this is going on, 300 miles away at John Lennon Airport in Liverpool, passenger services agent Kelly McCartney has hit a language barrier with a lady from a country we know all too well here on Arthur TV.
What is it? What do you smell?
French people.
I don't speak French, I'm afraid.
Earlier this morning, Kelly booked Joseanne Delphine on a flight to Paris, but she's arrived too late to check in.
I did tell you this when you booked it, you had to be here for 1 o'clock.
Taxi.
I understand, but I did say to be here for 1 o'clock. The check-in's closed now.
She's coming now. She's on the telephone. She's very busy.
Can I just tell you, when you did the booking today, we did not struggle one bit in understanding each other. I clearly wrote down and told you. Well, you understood me today. You understood when we were speaking about your nails.
Tell you what, these Scouse girls do an absolutely cracking job of standing up to customers on this programme.
You understood all that.
She has the option of transferring onto the next flight, which leaves in 6 hours, but it's not what Joseanne wants to hear.
Don't go.
I understand, excuse me.
Give me
can
my money
explain?
Because I come to pay this here. Je dormirai ici s'il le faut, mais tout le monde saura. You give me my money. Finish.
I've told you I can't do that. Can
call
I just
me your boss.
She's coming now.
Je ne peux pas rester. Le vol il est à 55.
I can't understand what you're saying. I told you I can't understand you.
You speak English quickly. I speak French quickly.
Well,
okay.
I can't understand you French slowly. I can't speak every language of the world.
Pas possible. Can I do?
As the first round of France versus England kicks off, Mrs. Choti is still trying to annoy her way onto the plane back in Luton.
Excuse me, do you think you could let my husband know that I'm going to get there
tonight? Once you come to the front of the queue, there's other people in it at the moment.
I didn't know that you wanted me to come to the front of the queue.
Well, no, you need to wait with everyone else because other people
are
queuing up before you. Yeah.
I've got to wait.
It's still a no for Mrs. Choti on the Zurich flight, and she's now been transferred to Geneva. But Leo is facing a tricky situation. The Zurich plane is still on the ground.
Oh my God. How long's it delayed altogether?
How long's it delayed?
This fetch ain't gonna take, I'll have to plead with her. Unless it's gonna be a nightmare. Having a bit of a nightmare at the moment. The aircraft's delayed 1.5 hours. Her family's in there in the departure lounge. She's on the Geneva. So they're gonna be congregating in the departure lounge together. But they've spoken to dispatch, pleaded with them, and there's no way you can get them on because she's got bags as well, which I can understand. I mean, it's like the greatest good for the greatest number. We've got 145 people on it who are gonna go on time. But if we make an amendment to the paperwork, we're gonna get a delay on it. I'm just gonna plead with dispatch one more time. That's all I can do, really.
Leo makes one more call to see if he can get Mrs. Choti on the flight.
Hi, it's Leo. I rang about 15 minutes ago and spoke to someone down there, and they said that we couldn't take any LMCs on the Geneva, on the Zurich, sorry. But it's really, really urgent. It's because the family is already on the Zurich and they're in the departure lounge and she's going to Geneva. So they're going to be congregating in the middle.
You don't like to see that kind of behaviour being rewarded, but with the potential clash, Leo is piling on the pressure behind the scenes.
We can take them. Superb, cheers mate, thank you. We're going to take them now after all that. Can you believe it? She wasn't the nicest people as well. I think people think they can come and if they shout, I want to get on my flight, they think they can get on it. And it's not because of that. Which she's obviously going to think it is.
But Mrs. Choti has already heard the good news and is all set to join her husband for the flight home to Zurich.
I think I'm relieved. It's a good story in the end. But I think one had to make a fuss to get there, otherwise you were not going to get anywhere.
She wants to calm down. Just calm down for one minute.
Don't take EasyJet again.
Back at Liverpool, international relations are at an all-time low.
Still the same.
As well as insisting on a refund, Joseanne Delphine now wants another £500 back for tickets she booked for her family to fly the following month.
I take the ticket from only my family. You give me only my money.
I haven't got the money to give you here in Liverpool. I haven't got cash to give you back for that
give
ticket.
Me check.
I haven't got checks.
Customer service.
Call police. You call police because when I don't have my money, I don't. I sit here.
I haven't got the money to give you back. I haven't got the money.
With Joseanne threatening to stage a sit-in, Supervisor Joanne Dempsey has been called to referee.
Can I help you?
Boss?
Yeah.
Okay. I want to go to Paris today.
But the lady booked it for you before.
Okay. In Paris, when you don't have baggage, you speak French?
No.
Bon. When you don't have baggage, you come.
But we're not in Paris, we're in Liverpool, and the lady rose on
okay.
here. What time you have to be here?
I don't want anything. I want my money to take.
Well, we haven't got any money here to give you.
Je dormirai ici s'il le faut.
Sorry?
Tout le monde
just
sera.
I can't understand anything you're saying. And if you don't listen to what I'm saying, you haven't gonna have to speak to EasyJet in Luton.
Finish.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye, Felicia.
Eventually, Joseanne finally realises that if she wants to get back to Paris, she's going to have to compromise. She's given up on refunds and agreed to be on the return flight later in the evening.
That's the time there of the flight, 1945, but you need to be here 1900, OK? Okay, see you later. I just reckon because she was late, she's just being angry. And then she's just calmed down and realised she's not going to get anywhere anyway. Changed her mind. From not flying EasyJet ever again to flying tonight.
Another job well done for the Scouse girls. As it comes to the end of the evening, Leanne has one more tricky customer to deal with. A drunken Irish bloke. What a rarity.
How do we get to Dublin? How do you get to Dublin?
You have to use Ryanair service.
How do you get to there?
You have to book it over with the travel agents or over the telephone with them.
How do we get to Dublin?
We don't travel to Dublin, so you won't be travelling with us.
Yeah. How do we get to Dublin?
However you want to get to Dublin.
Can I help you?
Yeah.
You have to travel with Ryanair.
How do we get to Dublin?
I was crying too, isn't it?
In Liverpool, Joseanne Delphine is back and she's finally checking in to her flight to Paris. She's on time.
Your flight's delayed 35 minutes.
Have a check-in.
No, it's later.
It's late, yeah.
But EasyJet isn't.
This morning when I come, it's not later.
No.
And communicating with the locals isn't getting any easier.
And now, what can I do?
I don't understand you, I'm afraid.
What can you do now?
Yeah.
We'll go down to the little departure lounge.
I'm late 5 minutes. She said no, but you can't go.
You'd missed your
but
flight this
now
morning.
It's 35. You know, anybody not perfect. Personne n'est parfait dans la vie. You know what is it yet?
I have to go to Dublin, probably.
As Joseanne finally boards her flight, Leanne is still struggling to get across the idea that EasyJet don't fly to Dublin.
The information desk for the reservation. Goes to the information desk.
I'm lying
there. How do you get to Dublin? How do I get to Ryanair? You live right here. Where's right here? I go to Dublin, right? I'm going to Dublin.
What a loose bloke. Even if EasyJet did fly to Dublin, Leanne wouldn't have let him on.
I wouldn't have let that gentleman travel because he was drunk. And the policy is that passengers who are under the influence of alcohol are not allowed to travel on an aircraft due to safety reasons.
Tell you what, I know I've got a bit of a bromance going on with Leo in this series, but I think I've got a bit of a thing for Leanne. What do you reckon? Team Leo or Team Leanne? Actually, who says I even have to choose? Well, she forgot about the golden rule. It's okay when it's in a three-way. It's not gay when it's in a three-way. With a honey in the middle, there's some leeway. The aerials break in a 1-2-3-way. That was a joke, YouTube. Please don't demonetize this video. Oh, anyway, that is unfortunately all we have time for today. As always, thank you guys for stopping by and watching today's video. I'm really glad you guys are still enjoying this series because there are so many more good freakouts to come. If you want to make sure you don't miss out on the next video, hit subscribe down below if you haven't already, and I'll see you on the next video.